kids, I'm Callie Lewis. You're watching Geek Brief TV. This is Brief 336, brought to you by Drobo. I gotta tell you, if you're letting me call what I'm giving you this week tech news, you're being very kind and I thank you. It's a quiet week. Actually, this first story isn't too shabby in terms of tech. It's a web service called Muxtape. We all know the mixtape is the quintessential DIY creative vehicle that even those of us with zero musical talent can use to express ourselves. That form of self-expression was carried over from the cassette to burn CDs, but something like a CD can never be as groovy as a cassette with a handwritten label. Muxtape.com probably isn't that groovy either, but it's still really cool. You start by creating an account. You can upload up to 12 songs. The songs have to be from different artists and different albums. When you're done, the collection is available to play at the click of a link. Pixaloo is a blog where an anonymous Photoshop artist is giving us a look at what some of our favorite characters would look like if they were flesh and bone human beings. Here's what Homer Simpson would look like. After comments, the artist felt like he should have done something with hair since the cartoon Homer isn't completely bald. He also displays the photos of the real people he used to capture textures to create the real Homer. I think the second guy is Rush Limbaugh. In the world of video podcasting, we're all looking for a unique way to create a set. I use monitors and lighting, MacNews Weekly uses a green screen, Command In uses Urban Outdoors, Lab Rats uses a cat. The big question for me is who will be the first video podcaster to use myphotowall.com to create a unique look? You actually don't need to be a podcaster, you can just be a mom wanting to do your kid's room in a unique way. It starts with a photo that you upload to the website, scale it, crop it, then purchase it. The sample walls displayed on the myphotowall.com website look out of this world amazing. And by the way, it's photo with an F. So since I'm working on the edge of legit tech news, I might as well tell you about the situation we've gotten ourselves into. Don and Drew from the funniest audio podcast you'll ever download invited us to their special 4th of July event. Of course, we said we wanted to go because Don and Drew inspired us to want to quit our day job and podcast full time. Don and Drew are heroes in our lives, and hey, Neil has a crush on Don, and I'm fine with it because I kind of do too. After we said yes, D&D sent us the details. We'll be camping out, primitive style. We won't be taking our RV. We'll be sleeping in a tent. Well, if I'm going to sleep in a tent, I want it to be unique, dagnabbit, and I think I've found one. It's called the Treepee, and it's a pure pyramid-shaped tent that hangs off the ground from a branch. I would expect it to be pretty comfortable since you don't have to sleep on the hard ground. It also comes in pinks, which makes Neil happy. I kid Neil because I love Neil. Last week, you might remember Shannon has a special question for Rachel. Tonight, Shannon called.
Hey, Neil and Callie, this is Shannon. Appreciate your help with the proposal. And good news, she said yes. I'll be emailing you guys here shortly. Thanks.
So congrats to Shannon and Rachel. I called them back and Rachel was all squeals. Hopefully we'll be able to go to the wedding. We need a new link from the Will You Marry Me ad on paidbypixels.com. So Shannon, if you want to change where that goes, just let me know. One of you, and you know who you are, ordered a Drobo from Amazon.com using my affiliate account. I got paid, but you didn't save as much as you could have by buying direct from DroboStore.com using my code Cali, C-A-L-I. My code is worth $50, and having your data stored on a Drobo is priceless because Drobo keeps it safe. I'm Callie Lewis. Thanks for watching, and thanks to everyone on Ustream. Woo! Woo. You're used to the space bar. There's a sweet spot on the knob. In a world of video podcasting, we're all looking for a unique way to create a set. I use monitors and lighting.
In a world.
Well, that's what I keep thinking. In a world. Okay.